Hello world, WayofTime here, bringing to you another episode of EEPower. So, I went on a bit of a mining expedition, found a bit of gold mainly, and I went for diamonds. I had to go quite far, but thankfully I managed to, when condensing down the gold, get 16 diamonds. So, hopefully this will be enough to get most of the other stuff that we're going to need. Unfortunately, since I was looking for those main ingredients, I didn't have a chance to look for anything that might help as well. So, we only have this. So, let's actually get started with our sorting area that we're going to want to do, and also the processing chain. So, as you can see, I am currently using the Faithful 32X Texture Pack. It is quite reminiscent, in fact very reminiscent, since, well, it's based on vanilla, on all of the vanilla mod Minecraft items. So as you can see, most of it's pretty much the same, bookcases, etc., enchanting table, and all of that fun stuff is pretty much as it should be. So I don't think there's too many differences in this. If I notice any ones that may be confusing at first glance, I'm going to try to explain if I actually know what they are at first glance. You'll pretty much be one of the first few to know. So, let's actually get started. So, what we're going to want to do is perhaps have a little fun with our routing behaviors. So, we're going to want to save these diamonds for another part, because I want to really advanceify the sorting machine system at a later time, but it doesn't look like we have all of the resources needed. At least those 16 diamonds are not enough to make a sorting machine that I feel would be, well, perfect for what we're doing. So I'm going to not quite do it right off the bat how I want it to do. Basically, I want to have a migration between factorization and the general red power sorting machine behavior. I want to have like a barrel system that has all of our important stuff, and if it can't find a spot in there, to send it off to some sort of buffer for some secondary sorting that will go into miner chests, which frankly will probably never get filled to that point anyways. So we'll have to make sure we can remember that in the future, but just doing some simple sorting in the meantime will probably be all we are able to do. So simple sorting in the sense that we'll just use some basic chests for now. So we're going to need our tube stuff, which our tube stuff must be downstairs. I'm not too sure about the banister, but hopefully I do get used to it eventually. It's an item transport, dagnabbit. Is it actually an item transport? Okay, apparently I need to clean my tube, so I'm going to try to look for those and then be right back with a vengeance. And they were in my inventory the entire time. Who would have thunk it? So you have to be wary of the solar panels. They may need to be moved in the future, but I'm hoping something similar for now, or something easy enough like this. Now, it doesn't need to be too much of a sorting system as of currently. Hopefully, we will have it a bit better. I'm not really satisfied with how this looks, but I suppose that will be how we have to have it. Because currently there's going to be a lot of recipes that need to go to those two items. I suppose we can worry about that at another time. It's just going to be a bit troublesome, but once we get enough resources to get some factorization dark iron, it should be good. So let's work on the actual ore processing, since that will probably be the easiest part to get out of the entire situation. So, we need to shove the stuff into thermal expansion machines while maintaining the ability to have it sorted, A, and B, have a reasonable buffer. So we're going to need to make a few relays. So let's see, relay, obviously it's going to require some red doped wafers. We got more than enough of those. And it needs transposers, so I'm thinking we'll make three of those. So here we go, we got some wood as well, and it's going to require some redstone, which we are starting to get a little low on. Which means if we're low at this point in the game, we are going to need to go out on another mining expenditure at a later point. So let's see. We'll also need a buffer. Sorry, three buffers for this. Some more wood jacketing, and then I think we will be good. So buffers will require some auxiliary materials, which are obviously the iron fences, which obviously we are in no way lucky to actually obtain right off the bat. So we are going to have to go with a glistening alternative, which is to say magic. I mean alchemy. Alchemy, yes. Alchemy is the key. So let's go get some iron bars. And we'll need a bit more wood. Let's just go with an entire stack. That is always how I like to conduct business. Just go a stack of wood, figure out what you need later. Yep. Stack of this. We might as well go for buffers. Because, hey, why not? We're gonna use them in the future anyways. So might as well just splurge a bit. So wafers here. And then transposers. Let's just get two relays and call it a day. Sort our inventory and then see about this. Now we're gonna want to go with some covers. I think some just standard stone covers will be good enough for us. I really don't think there will be anything serious needed to be about that. We're also going to need some paint, which we have some paint stuff over there, anyways. So let's get rid of all of this. Because it frankly won't help us, seeing as well, it probably will help us, but I guess we'll worry about that at a later time. So, let's see. Cover this up so it can easily enough go into here and here. There we go. And we'll need to have this send off to two different paths. And that is going to be an issue later. We'll probably want some marble panels or just jut out a wire to get that. Worried about, so to speak. Okay, so need to. That would be simple. If we put that there and a color tube there. So we'll have a color tube here and color tube here and then a relay here. That should be all we need to do. And I think that is. So let's go get some fashionable stuff and checking. Okay, good. Can't get caught. In this sorry excuse of a position. Yes, I know. Shush. Nope, obviously. That was a bad time to not shift click way. Bad time indeed. Okay, so now that we have that, we can just cover this up and we'll be able to paint that. Once and for all, I say. Once and for all. We need to cover this up as well. And cover that up, and then once we stop hopping around, we should be good. So there we go. We just need another one there, and presto! So we need to get our white and our orange paintbrush and demonstrate our artistic knowledge of how to be complete moronic independencies. I honestly don't know. Okay, orange was there already. I needed my white. Cannot live without my white stinks. And there we go. So, white paintbrush is for this area. There we go. And orange paintbrush is for there. We should have a reasonable buffer for everything, and it is quite compact. Compact enough that if we were to need one, we could put a sorter right here. And it should work perfectly for any extras that we may or may not need. Now, do we have access to that? Not easily, though it will work out, I am sure. So let's see. What are we going to need? We're obviously going to need some samples for this to work. And also, we'll need to open this up so that we can put that tesseract down once we have it. Crafted. Speaking about tesseracts, we'll need I think a total of four of these, which will require some tin ingot crafting, which I might have actually found some tin while I was out, so I'm gonna look a bit, see if it's actually in our processing chain, then create four tesseracts, two for items, and then two for our non-items, you know, liquid uses and such. Shut up. Okay, so our other tesseracts are currently cooking up. We've got a few unattuned tesseracts, and we have a bit of iron as well as redstone. I went out and mined about 16 tin ore and put the tin dust, iron dust, as well as the ore itself into the machine over there so that it now knows what to look for. So we need four pneumatic servos. We need quite a bit of this stuff. First, we'll make the item tesseract. It'll require a bit of silver, our unattuned tesseracts, as well as slightly more tin. So silver we can easily find over here, or rather relatively easy to find. Or am I just blind and can't see it? We're gonna need some copper anyways, so let's get that. And I am probably the most blind person in the world because I can't find my chunks of silver. Okay, obviously they were hiding from me. Don't know why. Maybe it doesn't like being put in places where it doesn't say yes to. Stands cool, kids. Okay, so unattuned tesseracts. We got two item tesseracts. This will be for our item transferal back home. And then we'll have our liquid tesseracts, which will feed our engines. We're gonna need a bit more of silver. Yay! More fun silver stuff. Let's just grab the whole lot. And we are going to need to do a bit more manual mining soon enough, so let's keep that in mind for later. Yeah, you probably don't even think I'm trying. Believe me, I'm not. So, unattuned tesseracts can't be placed down on the ground. That would have been an interesting floor to have. But we have two liquid tesseracts pretty much ready, and I'm not too sure if they're willing to transfer our liquids for other uses. So, what are we going to need to do? Probably make a few more energy conduits. This will be for our quarry. And we're also going to want to make, I think, two, three engines? Yeah, three nice and fancy engines of stuff that I can't even think of. Yes, they're the combustion engines. Why wouldn't I? Now, on the top of the combustion engines, I was kind of debating with myself. I know it sounds corny, but debating about efficiencies of designs and whether you should take one design over another just purely because it's more efficient. Now, the main reason that I got into this argument with myself was because, frankly, the efficiency to convert into the fun stuff required for the, how do I put this, for the EU production from fuel, let's say that. So, to get the EU from the fuel, what I currently have are the nice diesel generators over there. Sure, they could be better, but oh well. And then I was doing the math, and if I put the fuel into combustion engines, put those into magma crucibles, put those magma crucibles, the lava from the magma crucibles into geothermal generators or the thermal generators from Gregtech, and then take the EU from that, it's actually much more efficient than going with this route. I'm not too sure if it's actually Greg's plan for that to be the case. He wouldn't necessarily give us another generator, an entirely different generator, if he didn't have some sort of good reason for it. So I'm under the assumption that he knows of. He must know of the deficiency. Probably the only reason he has the diesel generator in the first place is to say that if you are a lazy ass, say me, for some reason just want to convert all of their spent fuel into much cleaner alternatives of EU-ness, go ahead. Otherwise, there are other options if you want to convert it into a relatively painful... Okay, now you're just trolling me. Can I have my pistons? Thank you very much. And now I can't even pull the dang stuff out of it. I swear, it's like my sister or something. So, let's actually make these engines and throw that in and that in. So, I don't know. This kind of gives me a debate of whether I should do it just for the hell of it, because these may be more inefficient, but they're almost kind of fun seeing set up just to put the fuel in, and it's almost not fun to just do the same thing over again by just converting lava into energy, or converting energy into lava into energy, just to go through some sort of inefficiency. And power converters exist, I know that, and I kind of don't want to use them because I feel that they're cheaty, but is it cheaty to use the same tried and true method all the time? I'm not sure, as long as you put your own twist to it, I suppose, but I pretty much file nail in the coffin. I suppose the fact that I have to go get the fuel in the first place to throw it into, say, combustion engines to further process, that I can consider a bit different, but you know what? I'm just gonna shut up and try to do a bit more of this minecrafting so as to not further horrify the problem. So, we're going to need to go get some landmarks. Unfortunately, this will help us set up, or rather is a requisite in setting up our quarry. So let's get the landmarks just simply like so. This will be for our quarry, and now we're going to need another thing, which is a chunk loader. So chunk loaders require ender pearls, gold, and enchantment tables. That's why I spent a bit of extra time diamond hunting. And we might have just enough. In fact, we pretty much have just enough to get everything. We're going to need a bit of extra leather because we're going to need the books. Ender pearls we can convert from 8 iron in total. So let's convert the iron first of all. And we're also going to need gold, I suppose. So do we have enough gold? We need 10 gold. And that's not enough, so we are going to need to convert these, first of all, 1, 2, and then all of these into our other pieces of gold. So, now that we have our gold, now that we have our diamonds, we are going to need our obsidian as well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're also going to finally need to put a nail in the coffin of saying ridiculous stuffs just to fill the void. There we go, we got that, we got our diamonds, and we are going to need books. Books, books, books. Do we have any books? Not for the taking, I wouldn't assume. We got one piece of leather left. Those eggs are actually going to prove useful in the future to make our routers, because I think the routers require eggs as well as ender pearl material, so we'll keep that in mind. And we had extra gear, so no books here either. And we got one piece of leather, that'll be useful. And let's actually just go and kill some cows, shall we? Oh, creepers, where are you? Okay, books ready, and I... Bloody hell. Anyway, so we managed to decimate our cow farm quite a bit. That couldn't be helped, but now that we have our enchanting tables, you can go further onwards, and my mouse is not having a happy day, apparently. No, I don't want to go that way. Why are you trying to make me do that? Don't you realize that there's probably a better way? I know there's probably a better way, but whatever. This is Minecraft. We go for what we want to do. So, chunk loader... Not much of a hallmark area for it to be, and it's mainly so that we can keep this area chunk loaded, and also our energy and, sorry, our fuel that we need. So, if we put it over here, yeah, let's put it up there. Let's just go up quickly, And quietly, relatively, assuming that our mouse is going to capitulate, dang it, we will be able to place it in the corner right here, I think. Yeah. So let's show the lasers and do a square region. That area is chunk loaded, I assume. No reason to worry about that area, and that area is picture perfect. So that will probably be all we need to chunk load. If we have too many chunk loaders, eventually we may or may not lag. So we'll have to keep that in mind. And finally, going to need our two lovely tesseract sets. Our item tesseract, which will be our second set of item tesseracts, in fact, which we're probably going to need to drop down. Do we have any of that? No, we do not. So we're going to need to pick some up. So item tesseract, we'll send the stuff here. We'll go with two. And for this, we are going to call it quarry out. Put. And I think save it, set it, forget it. And now that we have that, let's just forget it even existed. Now, with our liquid tesseracts, we can throw them on as well. Liquid tesseracts, I believe we're going to put it here. Yep. And for this, we'll put as two. Quarry liquid output, or input rather, because it's going to the quarry. Derp, set, save, forget. Not quite forget, because we are going to need one minor modification to it, which should be a little obvious to those people who are actually paying attention. We are going to need to go get our liquiducts. We got enough liquiducts, that's good. Another thing we're lacking, though, however, is our reserves of liquid conduits. So we'll need to make some liquid conduits as well, because frankly, they may be necessary. Also, if we get some pneumatic tubes and some relays, I'm sure these will help. And hey, why not? We can set that up. Okay, so liquid conduits. There's also one other thing we need to grab from it. So liquid conduit here and attach. And there. Okay, so we got that. And probably if we set this configured to send only, and this needs to be receive only, we should be pretty much set for what we need to do. Obviously, we will need to tweak this so that we can do other portions, such as getting all of the ores available, and maybe the ones that we don't want to process will just, you know, not process. So these we'll probably not worry about, and there's one more machine which may be useful for our accumulation. Well, the quarry for one, going to our mining site and then not having our quarry may just suck a little. So let's go to the site. I have one sort of picked out already. Basically, it's a desert region, which I think is flat enough. We'll have to survey it a bit more, but hopefully I get to it when it's still light out. So without further ado, let's just travel to that location in hopes of not dying. Here we are. We have managed to arrive at our destination. If you would please unfasten your seatbelts, you may enjoy the lovely refreshments. So we got our nice little quarry area with a few squids and uninvited guests. Hopefully it won't be too bad. I think I see a nice water area that may or may not need to be covered up in the future. So what is the best area for this to be set at? I'm thinking maybe if we set it here and go outwards like that, or if we set it in fact here. Just because of that, we're setting it here. Okay, so we will need to first set out our landmarks. And because I am an idiot, did I actually bring any sort of redstone signal? Yes, I did. And for those of you who were wondering, I remember the conduits. So we need to go way off into the distance over here to set our next landmark. We'll go for the biggest size quarry that we can. I know it is going to be a while before we actually see any sort of decent gain from this, but it should work. And there's also a totem over there, which we may need to be mindful of. Hopefully, it doesn't signal baddies from occurring, but actually only goodies. So maybe I am a little too naive for actually thinking that, but oh well, I am who I am, and I do not plan to change, no matter how nicely you ask me. So, let's find here. It should be soon. Let's actually find it, please. And here we go. Landmark. Ho. Said ho. Ho! And there we go. We may have had too many landmarks now that I think of it. Assuming that it actually assumes the proper fetal position, and we will be okay. Here we go. Activate. Wingardium Leviosa. Circular sun. Not sure if like. I remember the first time that these. There we go. I remember the first time that these landmarks came into Buildcraft. It was quite a while ago, actually. And something I should have checked is our grid lines. We should be good. We're in chunk boundaries as long as we keep the chunk stuff in here. Might be a little too limiting now that I think of it. If we go over here, we should have a bit more. Now, if you're confused, these are actually chunk boundary lines that are brought up by NEI, I think it is. This gives a more visual representation, and if we build most of our stuff in here, we'll put the chunk loader in there. I know quarries do have chunk loaders, but frankly, I am going to be a bit careful on that. So, if our quarry is here, we're going to need to provide energy to it. And that will be an easy enough thing to do by just doing that. We'll need to give energy at the top, redstone signal at the bottom. And of course, we will need to wrench it into place because it's not going to be cooperative right off the bat. Speaking of which, we'll also need to have that, and here. Now we have energy to the area. We'll need to get extra levers and so on, but that should be good. Now we're going to need the liquid conduits, which will go here, and are going to need to be supplied by our own resident water boy. I don't know. Come here, water boy! Away! So, nice defined area for the water will be like here and here and here, just gutting out this place, and then I remember that I have one of those. So, aqueous accumulator. Do I have a bucket of water? Any more? You might do. I don't know. Powering it by that may not be the best idea. I'm gonna go over there, get some more water, then get my other lever because frankly, I might need it. Okay, got the most important part of this entire deal, the lever. We'll be able to manage to manipulate so much science, you will have no idea where the science went. So, we're also going to need energy, aren't we? That might have been important. Might have been important. And we can't exactly build there. Or else, okay, let's take this down. Thankfully, there's nothing in it for us to worry about, but we do have the general gist of the build. Just need it moved over slightly by maybe putting it on top of here instead. There it is. Haha. Sucker! And then putting it like that, we're going to need to have our liquid stuff coming here. And then this here, 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 wrench together. And finally, have our other bucket of water to speed up the process. And also, we will need light here. Thank you. Have a good day. So, now that we got some light spreading the word of love, affection, and combustion. We'll be able to get our liquid. We got our liquid. We can get our energy as well. Like so. Which will also need a bit of tweaking, like this. That. Okay, that's good. And finally, well, next part at least, we'll put our liquid tesseract down. And get that set. And we got some fuel. And it'll start fueling up all of this, and we should be pretty much ready to go once we flick those three switches. I'm gonna be careful not to let anything get too close. So if we encircle our spawning radius, hopefully nothing nasty gets to us right now. This would have been better if we had a bit more time for daylight. Anyways, so we'll have a golden transport pipe and a diamond pipe. Let's put our F9 on. Okay, we got enough room. Golden transport pipe, it'll be the exit. We'll have a filter here. This will just be for the regular riffraff. Why do I have two diamond pipes? I have no clue. Anyways, so for this, we will want to have garbage going this way. Garbage going this way, actually, and the non-garbage going this way. Non-garbage will then ceremoniously get sent through the item test rack, which will be the quarry output. And red will have this, and we're going to need to get some gravel. So I'll find a source of gravel, put the flint and the gravel in, and then we should be good in terms of that. I don't think there's other useless stuff that we have to worry about right away, but we'll worry about that later. Okay, thankfully I managed to also find a handy lava source nearby, so we might want to cover that up with something a little more solid. So I'll just give the dirt to it, and we managed to, when getting the gravel, get exactly one piece of gravel and then one piece of flint, so that'll be useful. So we got that. Item test rack is a go. We got enough, well, item transport to do. So all we need to do is flick the switch, which we'll do to make first after determining whether there's spiders or not. Which, as you may notice, there's a bunch of angry critters going for us right away, which is not exactly the most fun for us to have. Okay, let's get the grid off. It won't be necessary for a bit. Ha! Ha! Can you die? Thank you. Okay. Let's play this. And the aqueous accumulator will be enough for all those combustion engines. So as soon as it starts, as you can see right now, we should be good. Now the next thing that we will want to do is set up our chunk loader, which is right here, which will need our F9 again. Let's see, this is the maximum we need chunked up. So one over, and pretty much where it is right now is where we need to have it. So let's go in and pillar up. It'll take the wood very quickly, so let's pillar up as quickly as we can. Oh my god, oh my god. Not how I planned things to go. Not how I planned things to go, not how I planned things to go. Let's kill those first. Okay, this is going badly. Okay, let's get out here. Let's get out here. And get that stuff out here. You know, it would be lovely to have some other sort of awesome to go on, but obviously I am missing that. If a creeper goes and attacks me while I am like this, I will not be happy for obvious trolley reasons that apparently is not a creeper. Okay, so good, good, good. Get you to maximum height possible. And there we go. Should get this down. Show lasers. That's good. That is just. I think it's just off. So, just in case, I'm gonna increase it. Now, I'm gonna fine-tune this. Be right back. Judging by the laser lines over there, we should be good. So, this area. It's now officially chunk loaded. We're just going to need to have a little luck with the zombies, which may not like us for some obvious reasons. Let's get our wood down and not get trolled by that. Okay, so this area, we're gonna have to hide the lasers. This area is relatively safe. We just need to, once we get this working. This stuff should start working on giving us some more materials. So I think that is pretty much a wrap. Maybe it might be nice to see if this stuff goes onwards to higher heights. Though that may not be a possibility, seeing as I am out of food. Get away. I am showing how much I love this place right now. Okay, so throw that in. It may or may not have gone, but oh well. Well, that's all the time we have for this episode of EE Power. I know, cliffhangers, I hate them. If you like what you see, don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe to future episodes. Okay, I'm gonna check. I'm not that horrible of a person. Ah, okay. Wave time here. Signing off. Have a wonderful day. Oh, crud, oh, crud, oh, crud, oh, crud, oh, crud.